No, I wouldn't say that. I would say that you need a bit of luck to get some runs in these conditions some days. I felt like a few times this series I haven't had a lot of luck, so I had a little bit of luck today, but I wouldn't credit poor fielding for the runs, no. I think a pretty similar wicket to what we saw in Hyderabad. There's obviously no grass on it. There are a lot of cracks, so the ball, if it catches a crack, can deviate either way. The ball was roughing up, so we saw a lot of reverse swing. It seemed to me like a pretty similar wicket to Hyderabad. So I think it will pan out pretty much like that. If you bowl well enough, it's a tough wicket to score on, but if you get in, it's a hard wicket to get out on. The team score?
Yeah,
I think you can't judge a wicket till both sides bat on it. We saw in Hyderabad that it was that one brilliant partnership that brought us undone, but aside from that, it could have been a competitive total. So I don't think we've got enough runs at the moment, but if we can get another 70 or 80 in the morning, 350 runs on the board on a wicket that's playing a few tricks already, we believe that, that's lots of runs if we bowl well. I think that's the key there. If you bowl poorly, it doesn't matter what the surface is like. Not comparing me to the other guys, I don't think that's fair because that's the game. But it did feel the last two tests half a mistake and you were back in the change room. And I guess, that half mistake was me going outside my plan. So it's my fault, but it can go the other way as we saw today. They're great conditions to play in. They're so challenging as you just have to be on your game every ball. There's no doubt about that. So, a little bit of luck never goes astray. That's a good question. Probably not a whole book, no. But it would have made a good couple of pages. Yeah, good question. I think my plans have almost come full circle. It felt in Chennai, I guess coming over here, I had in my mind that I really needed to put pressure on the spinners by attacking them. And I made, that mistake in Chennai, and not a great shot in the first innings when I was set. So I guess it's sort of come full circle back to how I want to bat, and that's fighting and grinding them out. And if it takes all day to get 86 or 50, it doesn't really matter. My job, I think, in these conditions for this team is to bat for as long as I possibly can, and almost taking the runs out of it, just trying to bat that time, soaking up a lot of balls. We've got so many shot makers. So I guess my game plan's changed a lot in that sense, from putting pressure on them by putting pressure on them by them not being able to get me out, I guess. I don't know, you'd have to ask Michael. I think we've seen him play like that to left-arm spinner all series, and he's played beautifully. It was a pretty good piece of bowling from the other end, to be honest. First ball to turn and bounce past the bat. That's how he plays. He likes to get down the wicket. He's done it all series. I'm sure it was in his plan, and it didn't work out today, but we've seen how well he's been playing. It's rare for him to make a mistake, so I guess a bit of credit to the bowler.
Be back after the last test.
Oh, what did I present to the coach? Okay. No, what I said to Mickey was that I want to be accountable to bat a long period of time, and I put a figure on that. That's between me and Mickey, but that's what I wanted to be held to. I wanted to be held to a few other team things as well, but that's between me, Mickey, and the team. But my personal accountability is to bat a long time, so that's.
So you have succeeded.
Not for as long as I would have liked, but it felt like I did part of a job today for sure.
Thanks, everyone.